Hello students, welcome back to your English class. So I'm here again with you. Okay, as earlier we did nouns, proper noun, common noun, countable noun, uncountable nouns. We did that. I hope that the concept is quite clear to you and we did the exercise. Today we are going to begin abstract, concrete and material nouns. Although we have discussed it in earlier, but still now we will do it in brief and with exercise as from your book. So here we start. Abstract noun. Abstract nouns are the names of things we cannot see or touch, but we can hear, feel. Okay. Abstract noun, we cannot see or touch, but we can hear or we can feel. Examples: music. Can you touch music? You cannot touch music. You can, if you are playing music with your phone, you can touch your phone, but you cannot touch music. Love, truth, wisdom, boredom, etc. More than honesty, happiness. Okay, so these are abstract noun. Important points to keep in mind are, they are not made of any substance or materials. Obviously, if they are made of something, then you can touch them. Next, they cannot be seen, smelt or tasted. You cannot see them, you cannot smell them, and you cannot taste them. These nouns can be formed from adjectives, nouns, and verbs. These nouns can be formed from adjectives, nouns, or verbs. These are called abstract nouns. Qualities like kindness, loyalty, honesty are also abstract noun. Okay, you cannot see kindness, you can feel it. You cannot see honesty, you can feel it. When you lost something, it might be, or you forget something, like you forget your notebook, you kept it in other class and you forgot, and some student who has taken it, read your name and return it to you. Then you will, oh, thank you. It means he's honest and is worried for you. Okay? Like you feel it. You cannot see the honesty. You cannot see the concern he showed. But you can feel it. Now, as qualities like kindness, loyalty, honesty are abstract noun, and it can be formed from adjectives, nouns and verbs. How? Here we can see. Here, table number 1, adjectives. Second, abstract. So how? From adjective, abstract nouns are formed, like happy, happiness, brave, bravery, innocent, innocence, verbs and abstract noun. So how it formed? Agree, agreement, arrive, arrival, laugh, laughter. Coming to next, common nouns, abstract noun. How is it possible? See, child is common noun. It can be any child, but childhood is the abstract noun. Robber, you read the chapter, robber, a boy and a robber. So robber is common noun, and what they were doing, robbery. Robbery is abstract noun. Okay. Common noun, enemy and enmity is abstract noun. Okay. So, these are the example of abstract noun that are formed from adjectives, verbs and common noun. Here, next topic is concrete nouns. Concrete nouns are names of objects we can see and touch. Keep in mind, what you can see and touch is concrete noun. What you cannot see or touch is abstract noun. As the name suggests, abstract. Find out the meaning of abstract in the dictionary. Sample or example of concrete nouns are book. You can see or touch your mother. Yes, you can see or touch your book. Yes. Fleet, the Hogwarts Express. These are the example of concrete noun. Here, material noun. Material nouns are the words. This is given in very precise manner, but we have did it earlier with a. So you can switch to that video to know more details, and you can revise the topic from there also. Okay. Material nouns are the words used for materials or ingredients that other things are made from. Materials are the word. Material nouns are the words that use for materials. Have you seen the example like book? Book is concrete noun. It's an object. Okay. Book is concrete noun. It's an object. But the raw material or the sources that is used to make book is material noun. Like book is made of paper, and paper is also common noun. Paper is made of a pulp of a tree, and the pulp of the tree, name of the tree is papyrus. So here food is the material noun here. Like chair is object, but chair is made up of iron, so iron is material noun. Plastic is material noun, and steel, it can be material noun. Okay, like rubber, your slippers are made of rubbers. Gloves, eraser is concrete noun, but eraser is made of rubber, it is material noun. Glass here, you don't think that glass, where you used to drink your water, it's object, but the thing, glass, object which is transparent, which can be transparent. Okay. So, because we use glass to cover the windows also, okay. So, here you can see in the glass, windows are covered with the glass. So, glass is material noun. And some more, like earrings that ladies or the mother or your sister used to wear in the ears. So, the material that are made of earrings, it can be silver. Silver is material noun. It can be gold. It is also material noun or some other product. Okay. Like decks. Decks is concrete noun. But decks is made up of wood. So wood is material noun. Okay. Again, if I talk about something else like your bags. So bag is concrete noun. Bag is made of fabric. Fabric is material noun. Okay. Your pencil box is made of plastic. Pencil box is concrete noun, but plastic is material noun here. Okay. Do you know? See, he's asking. Do you know? Common nouns, material nouns, proper nouns, and collective nouns, all are concrete nouns. Because you can see and touch these all things. So these are concrete noun. Okay. Here, fill up the blanks with the names of the materials given below. Fill up the blanks with the names. Leather, tin, wood, rubber, cloth, paper. Only six. So we must have to fill these words in these sentences. We can make the mask. See how important the mask is nowadays. We can make the mask with either blank or blank. Okay. The shoemaker makes shoes from blank. Are tires made of blank? Cans are usually made of blank. Okay. The furniture is made of teak blank. Half of the answer you already got. Am I right? Yes. Teak is a type of wood. Teak is a type of wood. In the last sentence, teak is mentioned. So teak is a type of wood. So teak is proper noun here, and wood is common noun, and answer is wood. But wood we are filling here is as material. Okay. Cans are usually our countdown is started. We are going up in decreasing order. Cans are usually made of tin. Cans that you use to drink your soft drink, Pepsi, Coca-Cola. Okay. Are tires made of wood? No, paper. No, it's rubber. Tires are made of rubber. The shoemaker makes shoes from. It is, the answer is leather. Okay. We can make the mask with either paper or cloth. Cloth we call fabric. Fabric means cloth. Clear? So these are the answers. You only write the answers in your notebooks. Okay, beta. Next question we are having. This is read the sentences given below and fill up the blanks. Okay. Concrete noun. Options are concrete nouns and abstract nouns. So out of these sentences we first read and we fill in the blanks. Nana has a weakness for sweets. Simple. Nana has a weakness for sweets. You can see weakness? No, but you can see sweets. The sweets, example of concrete noun. Abstract noun is weakness. Second, his honesty is admired by people. His honesty is admired by people. People, common noun. Honesty, abstract noun. The dog is known for its loyalty. Loyalty, abstract noun. The dog, concrete noun. Mary was full of enthusiasm. Enthusiasm, zest, zeal. When you are so, if I allow you to go for the games period, if I allowed any one of you to go out of the house and let you play in the garden, and you will feel happy, enthusiasm. You are just ready to go. That is called enthusiasm. So Mary was full of enthusiasm. You can see Mary? Yes, Mary is concrete noun. Enthusiasm, abstract noun. Hunger had made the beggar weak. Hunger had made the beggar weak. Weak is adjective here. Beggar, you can see concrete noun. Hunger is abstract noun. Okay, hunger is abstract noun here. Moving to the next, which is collective noun. I hope that abstract and concrete nouns are clear to you. Collective nouns. Read the following sentences. Suzel bought a bunch of bananas. She presented her a bouquet of flowers. Bouquet, it's bouquet. I saw a flock of sheep grazing in the valley. Means the word bunch stands for a collection of bananas. Okay. Or bunch stands for a collection of keys. Or bunch stands for the collection of grapes also. The words bouquet stands for a collection of flowers. The word flocks stand for a group of sheep. So, if I say a bouquet of flowers, it means you will imagine that beautiful flowers are there in a collection, you know, and tied together like here in the picture. So, this we called bouquet. Okay? We used to say, give me grapes. No. Give me banana. No. We say, give me bunch of grapes. Bunch of banana. So, it means we are reading here collective nouns. What are collective nouns? Collective nouns are names of groups of people, animals, and things taken as one unit. Things taken as one unit. Like if I say constellation, it means, constellation means a group of stars. Clear? Here. Fill up the blanks with the suitable words. Take words from the blackboard. The blackboard is quite clear to us and quite not clear to us. First one is shoal, second is bundle, third is swarm, fourth is not clear. It might be choir, cluster, bunch, herd and peck. Okay, these are the words mentioned in the on the blackboard. A blank of wolves, a blank of star, a blank of fish, a blank of bees, a blank of sticks, a blank of grapes, a blank of cows, a blank of singer. Very easy. We have done this already. Again, you have to do, you only need to fill it. A pack of wolves, a cluster of stars, a shoal of fish, a swarm of bees, a bundle of sticks, a bunch of grapes, a herd of cows, and a choir of singers. Okay? A choir of singers. Fill up the blanks with the suitable collective nouns. Again, this is clear to you? Here, don't write answer. Write like a pack of wolves. Okay? A cluster of stars. So this will remain in your mind. Where you have to find out, it's better to write the answers. But when this belong to the sentence, so write this. Fill up the blanks with the suitable collective nouns. String, suit, fleet, army, bunch, couple, bouquet, and gang. A blank of thieves is active in the city. A blank of keys was lying under the pillow. A strong blank of soldiers was sent to the front. A blank of steps led to the main hall. There is a beautiful blank of pearls like in the showcase. We booked a blank of rooms in a 5-star hotel. A blank of ships is sailing across the sea. She presented a blank of flowers to her teacher. Some of the answer we already did. So now it's your turn to do it on your own and show the answer to me. Send the answer to me also. It's very easy. It's very easy. Any doubt, ask me. Okay? Or shall I do it for you? Okay, let's tell me the answers. A blank of thieves, a gang of thieves, a blank of keys, a bunch of keys, a blank of soldiers, there is always army, there is always army of soldiers, a blank of steps led to the main hall. What will the answer? Tell me. There is a beautiful blank of pearls, it's a string. We booked a blank of rooms, it's suit, a blank of ship, a fleet of ship. She presented a what? She presented a flowers. Here, a couple of steps led to the main hall. Not couple. Find out the answer and then send it to me. Okay. Fun corner. The picture shows the subject that you study in school. Write the name of a friend who you think likes the given subjects in the form of a sentence. Okay? The picture shows the subject that you study in school. Clear? Pictures are clear. Write the name of a friend who you think likes the given subject in the form of a sentence. Means you have to frame sentence, but you will mention the name of a friend. Like here is sports or a hockey or a football, whatever is mentioned. You see and check which friend of yours like this. Like here it is music class. So who liked the music class? Here it is science class. It is computer class. And here I think this is English class. So you only mention the name in the notebook. Talking corner, work in pairs एंड से द टंग ट्विस्टर गिवन बिलो 5 times एंड सर्कल द नंबर दैट यू से इट करेक्टली. ओके सो हियर इज द वे दैट हैज़ बीन गिवन एंड दैट विल हेल्प यू टू से दिस टंग ट्विस्टर. क्लियर? एंड यू कैन डू इट विद योर मदर और योर फादर. आइस क्रीम यू स्क्रीम वी ऑल स्क्रीम फॉर एन आइस क्रीम. यू विल स्पीक इट फास्टली, डोंट टेक टाइम. हाउ? एंड यू विल स्पीक इट 5 times. आइस क्रीम यू स्क्रीम वी ऑल स्क्रीम फॉर एन आइस क्रीम. आइस क्रीम यू स्क्रीम वी ऑल स्क्रीम फॉर एन आइस क्रीम. लाइक दिस यू ऑल विल से एंड प्रैक्टिस एंड लर्न इट. ओके डू द वर्क. थैंक यू एंड हैव अ नाइस डे.